Hi everyone, and welcome to this video clip. In this review note, we're going to be looking at setting up static routing on iOS devices. Got a pretty simple topology set up here. I have three networks. On this side, I have 10.100.1.0, 24-bit. On this side, 10.100.2.0, 24-bit. And in the middle, I have 10.100.255.0, also 24-bit. The goal in this particular exercise is to allow PC1 to be able to ping over to PC2. Right now, we can't do that because the routers only have the routes that are set up by default. If I look at router 1, show the routing table, I can see that the only two routes in the routing table are those to which I'm directly connected on the network. So 10.100.1.0, 10.100.255.0, 10.100.1.0 because of the IP address on the Gigabit Zero interface, which is 10.100.1.1, and 10.100.255 because of 10.100.255.1 IP address set on the Gigabit One interface. If I look at router 2, we're going to see something very similar. Again, I've got two directly connected routes, 10.100.2.0, again because of the IP address that's set on Gigabit Zero, and then 10.100.255.0 because of the IP address that's set on Gigabit One. If I pop over onto PC1 and try to ping out and see how far I can go, I should be able to ping my router on that network. And sure enough, that works great. I should be able to ping on the interface on the other side of that same router. And again, that works great. It's telling me my default gateway is set correctly on my PC. Now, if I try to ping to the next router, this should be a different story because the next router is not going to know how to send the traffic back to me. And sure enough, that's going to time out. So we need to fix that, and we're going to go and configure the routing on our routers to resolve this issue. I'll let that go while I come over here under router 1. First thing I'm going to do on router 1 is configure a static route so that will get us over to the 10.100.2 network. Go into global config for that. And I'm going to add in a route. So the route is going to be to 10.100.2.0, 24-bit network, subnet mask that corresponds to that. And then the IP address for my next hop is going to be on the IP of the interface of router 2 that connects to router 1. And my route is now added in. If I look at the routing table, we can see here that I've got my new static route configured. Okay. We need to do the same thing on router 2 so we can get back to the 10.100.1 network. So over here on router 2, again, I'm going to go into global config, and I'm going to add a route. Again, my route is going to be to the 10.100.1.0 network, 24-bit. And I'm going to send that to the IP address on the interface on router 1 that connects to router 2. Look at the routing table. Here is our new static route to the 10.100.1.0 network going to the connecting interface or the neighbor interface that's on router 1. At this point in time, the routing table should allow us to ping from router 1 on the 10.100.1.0 network over to PC2 on the 10.100.2.0 network. First of all, again, let's try pinging router 2, make sure we can get through to that. And we can. Awesome. And now let's try getting through to PC2. Excellent. So we can ping now from PC1 all the way through to PC2. Ping's grid return. That's all there is to set up static routing. Of course, you'll probably have a more complex environment. There'll be more networks. That's okay. We just have to add more routes. That's a wrap for the video. Hopefully this has been helpful for you, and we'll see you next time.